True discipleship implies true commitment. You are going to have to accept that. True commitment that holds strong to the enemy's onslaught. And true commitment to give you all to your God, gave his one and only Son for each and every one of you. You please turn to me to Proverbs 16:3. You are there? Paul says, commit thy works unto the Lord, and thy thoughts shall be established. And Ecclesiastes 9:10, you turn there with me also.
To overtake him, to sift him as wheat, to find
who search his character and find weaknesses to exploit. But God always has a plan. He always does for his children who decide to remain committed to him. Jesus himself says, "I have prayed for thee that thy faith fail not. I have prayed that ye remain committed. I have prayed that you find strength to hold on, even though the enemy is at war. I have prayed for your resolve." And Christ is certain that God will answer his prayers, because he says, "When thou art converted, strengthen thy brethren. When you get past this challenge, strengthen thy brethren. When you overcome temptation, continue to do my work. When you finally find victory, continue to feed my sheep." Christ tells Peter plainly that you're going to endure some tough times ahead. It's coming. You have enraged the enemy by accepting his call to the lead. He will not make it easy, but I have prayed for your faith, so hold on. Remain committed, says Christ, not just to Simon Peter, but also to you and me. Jesus Christ considers to Peter, you, and me, because he himself has commitment tested by the enemy, and he came out on top, fully committed to do his Father's work. Matthew 3:16, please ponder with me. And Jesus, when he was baptized, went up straightway out of the water, and lo, the heavens were opened unto him, and he saw like a spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting upon him. After Jesus was baptized, committed to the journey and mission ahead, the Spirit comes upon him, anoints him and covers him, surrounds him and guides him into the desert. Those 40 days with no food, shelter, all other voice could have been more unbearable. Cold and lonely at night, and desperately hot during the day. But with the Holy Spirit, he finds comfort, just as you can. With the Holy Spirit, he finds daily renewed power, as he is fed on the Lord, just as you can faithfully eat the Lord. With the Holy Spirit, he finds protection from the enemies, just as you can. With the Holy Spirit, he finds victory over repeated temptations, just as you can. Through the intense power of the Holy Spirit, Christ, the ultimate disciple of God, shows us what it means to be truly committed to God's will and mission, no matter where you are or what the circumstances may be. Ezekiel 36:27. Please turn there with me. Now I put my spirit within you, and cause you to walk in my statutes, and ye shall keep my judgment and do them. You too, just as Jesus can be truly committed to God's work and his mission, your discipleship can be the same as Christ's was. Full acceptance, the call and true commitment to follow God's will. Remain true in commitment to grow in your to God, and your growth as a disciple has its challenges. At times it may even appear impossible to your sinful and human eyes. But God makes it very clear for us that no temptation will come this way that we don't have the strength, but the power of God for us to get past. 1 Corinthians 10:13. You can all turn there with me. So has no temptation taken you, but such as common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able. But though with the temptations also make you to escape, that ye may be able to bear it. There is no situation that the enemy can use to test your resolve, that the power and presence of the Holy Spirit can't bring you through. You will find constant hope with the Spirit. You will find constant guidance from the Spirit, and you will find constant victory, both with the Spirit. Hebrews 2:18. This is the last verse that I will be reading for you today. Will you please stand there with me? And James, I believe it is. We're having trouble finding that. Yes. No, I asked. Please, sir. For in that he himself hath suffered being tempted, he is able to succour them that are tempted. Christ was tempted, just as you are. Although we, he has challenged, just as you have been. But despite his challenges, temptations, and pain, amid the distractions, the enemy flew his way. He decided to look beyond those things and remain committed, not only to his Father's will, but also to his commitment to saving you and me. And with this in mind, that we must contemplate the long commitment to God. Christ. The ultimate example of discipleship. Through the power of the indwelling Spirit, remain committed to us that we might have salvation through his name and blood. And so it must be for us as disciples that we remain committed to the power of the indwelling Spirit daily, so that this great love God has outlined for us will be fulfilled as we share the good news with all those in the world in need of God's saving grace through his Son's precious blood.
Amen. Amen.